Hi viewers, today we will be discussing about the muscular tissue. In this session, we will discuss the various type of muscle cells present within our body. So please stick around, we will be right back after the intro. Welcome back. So let us check out what are the important points which are present in the muscular tissue. So in our body, there are three types of muscle cells. Number one, voluntary muscles, involuntary muscles, and number three, cardiac muscles. Now see here, in the voluntary muscle, we do see that the cell is little bit of barrel shaped, or it is the cylindrical in shape. Now there are so many names of voluntary muscles. Number one, it can be called as striped muscle also, skeletal muscle, striated muscle, and the voluntary muscles. So I am coming once again. These voluntary muscles can be also called as striped muscles, skeletal muscle, striated muscles. It is called voluntary muscle because it can be contracted and relaxed at our sweet will. It is striped muscle because alternate dark and light bands are present. Now it is called the skeletal muscle because it is attached with the humerus bone and the femur bone or the long bones. So the skeletal system, it is attached with the skeletal system, so it is also called the skeletal muscles. Now let us check out what are the important points related to the voluntary muscle. Point number one, cells are long, non-tapering. Non-tapering means it is not pointed at both the ends. It is more or less cylindrical in shape. Then it is cylindrical and unbranched. So no branching is there. So cells are, point number one, cells are long, non-tapering, cylindrical and unbranched. Number two, the cells are multinucleated. These nuclei are present. Nuclei are present in a single cell. This is not the cell membrane. These are the alternate bands, dark bands, alternate dark bands. So don't mistake with the cell membrane. This is not at all the cell membrane. So this is a single cell. Here more than one nuclei are present. Then number three, actin and myosin are present. Actin and myosin are the two types of proteins which are present in the muscle cell. So right, in point number three, actin and myosin are present. Due to the actin and myosin overlapping, these dark bands are produced. Point number four, alternate light band and dark bands are present. These are the light bands and these are the dark band. Dark bands are produced due to the overlapping of light band and the dark band. Due to the overlapping of the actin and myosin fiber, these dark bands are produced. Then point number five, plasma membrane is known as sarcolemma. This is the plasma membrane. This plasma membrane is also called as sarcolemma. Sarco means the muscle and lemma means the plasma membrane. So another name of plasma membrane of muscle is sarcolemma. So you may get one question, what do you mean by sarcolemma? Sarcolemma is nothing but the another name of plasma membrane present in the muscle cells. Then point number six, protoplasm. Protoplasm is also known as sarcoplasm. So what is sarcoplasm? That this is the protoplasm of the muscle, is called the sarcoplasm. Then point number 7, the endoplasmic reticulum is known as sarcoplasmic reticulum. So question may come, what do you mean sarcoplasmic reticulum? The answer would be the endoplasmic reticulum of the muscle is called the sarcoplasmic reticulum. The myofibrils are present. This one structure is called the myofibrils. Mitochondria is present for the contraction and relaxation of the muscle. Huge amount of energy is required. That energy is supplied by the ATP, which are being produced inside the mitochondria. Number 10, it acts according to our sweet will. Since it acts according to our sweet will, that is why it is called the voluntary muscle. Then point number 11, it is attached with the long bones. The long bones means the femur, the humerus and the femur. Now let us check out, this is the involuntary muscle. Involuntary muscle, that means these muscles are not controlled by our sweet wish and will. This is more or less spindle shaped. This shape is called the spindle shaped. This involuntary muscle is also called as smooth muscle. That means alternate light bands and dark bands are not produced. Alternate dark bands and light bands are not present. This is also called visceral muscle. So what are the alternate names of involuntary muscle? It is smooth muscle and visceral muscle. Point number 1, it is spindle shaped. Number 2, uninucleated. This is one nucleus. This is present within the protoplasm of the muscle cell. Now see, the nucleus is red and the protoplasm or the cytoplasm is blue in color. It is because if you stain this muscle cell, generally in all the animal cells, if you stain it with hematoxylin and eosin, the red color eosin will be taken by the nucleus and the cytoplasm will take the hematoxylin, that is the blue color. So I have drawn the cytoplasm in blue and red and nucleus. So point number 1, it is spindle shaped. Point number 2, it is uninucleated. Point number 3, actin and myosin proteins are present. Alternate light band and dark band are absent. Then this point is remaining same. The plasma membrane of the muscle is called the sarcolemma. Then point number 6, protoplasm is called the sarcoplasm. Then endoplasmic reticulum is known as sarcoplasmic reticulum. Then myofibrils are absent. Then mitochondria present. Mitochondria is also present. It acts according to our sweet wish and will. It does not act according to our sweet wish and will. Then it is attached with gut. Gut means the intestine from the esophagus up to the rectum. It is called the gut and is also present in the urinary bladder. So this is the portion of the esophagus. Here the food bolus is present. So at the back, now this is the esophagus. This is lined by the smooth muscle. This is lined by the smooth muscle. So When the foot is present at this position, at the back, this involuntary muscle, which is lined by the gut wall, will contract in this way. And the front portion, it will get opened. The foot will drop over here. Then at the back, it will again contract, and the front, it will open. In this way, a pressure will be created by the involuntary muscle through which the foot will run down. That is why when we deglute, when we swallow any food object, after the forming the bolus within the mouth, when it runs down from the mouth to the stomach, you will find wave. This wave is called the peristalsis. This is caused due to the contraction and relaxation of the involuntary muscles. It is not controlled by our sweet wish and will. Now, last is the cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle, see, is the branch structure. It is the branch structure. These are the branching. These are the branching. And this is the intercalated disc. So, it is a very, very important question. Where do you see the intercalated disc? So, intercalated disc is present in the cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle is also involuntary in nature. Cardiac muscle is the muscle present within the heart. The heart muscle is composed of the cardiac muscle. So, it is a mixed type of muscle cells. It looks like almost voluntary muscle, but functions as involuntary muscle. I am coming once again. It looks like voluntary muscle, but it functions like involuntary muscle. It cannot be controlled by our sweet wish and will. Had it been, so we can control our, we would have controlled our heartbeats. But since it is involuntary in action, so we cannot control our heartbeat. At our sweet wish and will, it cannot be controlled. So it is, function is completely independent. See, now take a look of the function or the main points of cardiac muscle. It is branched in nature. These are the branching. Number two, multinucleated. This is not the plasma membrane. These are the intercalated disc. Then actin and myosin proteins are present. That is why contraction and relaxation are produced. And 5, 6 and 7 remaining the same. That is, the plasma membrane is known as sarcolemma, protoplasm is known as sarcoplasm, and endoplasmic reticulum is known as sarcoplasmic reticulum. Then mitochondria is present. It cannot act with our sweet wish and will, and it is present in the heart. So, by telling this, I am ending today's session. Hopefully, you understood today's topic. And please remember to like, subscribe and share the video. Should you found it helpful, please post the comment. Should you have any question, if you want to learn more, I recommend to check out our website, sciencecorner.com, and the playlist. Thanks so much for using sciencecorner.com. Bye bye for now. See you in my next video.